Welcome to St. Joseph's on this August weekend as we gather once again to welcome the Lord Jesus into our midst. My name is Karen Moeller, and leading us in worship today is Father Mike. This weekend, we celebrate the 20th anniversary of the Holy Family Adoration Chapel here at our parish. We thank God for this blessing, and we'll hear a personal testimony about the chapel at the end of Mass. Also today, we impart a blessing upon our college students as they prepare to return to school and continue their studies. As we listen to the gospel together this day, we realize that following Jesus has a price. He says that he has come to cast fire upon the earth. People in the past have paid the price and have endured division and suffering. Now it is our turn to hear the call of the Prince of Peace and to follow. Let us begin our worship now by raising our voices in praise of God with the hymn, All the Ends of the Earth, found in your program. But first, let us rise to greet the Lord and one another.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My brothers and sisters, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
On this beautiful dream cruise weekend, we've cruised here into the Lord's house to celebrate our love for God, to be challenged by Jesus in the gospel, to celebrate an anniversary of faithfulness, our Adoration Chapel this weekend, to give blessings to our young as they go to school. We have much to be grateful for, much to praise God for this day. Let's open our hearts to the Lord's presence, to Jesus' healing love and mercy. Lord Jesus, you call us to love God even more than our family members. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you cast fire upon the earth, the fire of God's love and mercy. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you offer the path to eternal life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, on earth peace, to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer.
Let us pray. O God, who have prepared for those who love you good things which no eye can see, fill our hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. In those days, the princes said to the king, Jeremiah ought to be put to death. He is demoralizing the soldiers who are left to this. He is demoralizing the soldiers who are left in this city and all the people by speaking such things to them. He's not interested in the welfare of our people, but in their ruin. King Zedekiah answered, he is in your power. For the king could do nothing with him. So they took Jeremiah and threw him into the cistern of Prince Malchiah, which was in the quarters of the guard, letting him down with ropes. There was no water in the cistern, only mud. And Jeremiah sank into the mud. Ebed-Melech, a court official, went there from the palace and said to him, "My lord king, these men have been at fault in all they have done to the prophet Jeremiah, casting him into the cistern. He will die of famine on the spot, for there is no more food in the city." Then the king ordered Ebed-Melech the Cushite to take three men along with him and draw the prophet Jeremiah out of the cistern before he should die. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us rid ourselves of every burden and sin that clings to us, and persevere in running the race that lies before us while keeping our eyes fixed on Jesus, the leader and perfecter of faith. For the sake of the joy that lay before him, he endured the cross, despising its shame, and has taken his seat at the right of the throne of God. Consider how he endured such opposition from sinners, in order that you may not grow weary and lose heart. In your struggle against sin, you have not yet resisted to the point of shedding blood. The word of the Lord.
Your servant is listening. Speak your words of wisdom, for the words you speak are everlasting life.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "I have come to set the fire earth on fire, and how I wish it were already blazing. There is a baptism with which I must be baptized, and how great is my anguish until it is accomplished. Do you think that I have come to establish peace on the earth? No, I tell you, but rather division. From now on, a household of five will be divided, three against two and two against three. A father will be divided against his son, and a son against his father. A mother against her daughter, and a daughter against her mother. A mother-in-law against her daughter-in-law, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law." The Gospel of the Lord. Every week, our parish webmaster sends out an email blast to parishioners who have signed up to receive the Sunday readings during the week. Many of you have signed up for this, and it amazes me how much of you read and pray over the scriptures before you come to Mass on the weekend. After receiving today's readings, one of our faithful men of the parish, I see he's here tonight, he emailed me with a question about this gospel passage. He quoted Jesus' words that we just heard. "Do you think that I have come to establish peace on the earth? No, I tell you, but rather division." And so he asked, "Are the many different religions and splits or divisions within given religions, are these by divine design?" In other words, he's asking, is it God's plan that there's so much division and strife, especially in religion? This is a good question. And many people today criticize all religion and blame religious belief and religious zeal and passion for violence in our world, divisions in the human family, and blame religion even for bloodshed. For example, the strife in Egypt right now, the killing and the protests, rather than blame the tyranny of the government, the overthrow of the democratically elected president, or look at the high unemployment rate there or the severe poverty, many choose not to look at those things, but to blame religious belief for the problems there. Indeed, we know Egyptian Christians, 15 million Coptic Christians, are being persecuted at this moment in the present conflict. But the problems are not simply because of religion. But it's a good question. Is division and strife part of God's plan, God's design for us? In our first reading tonight, we hear a portion of Jeremiah's story, the prophet of the Old Testament, who's called as a teenager to announce God's word. Of all the figures in the Old Testament, he's the one that most closely foreshadows Jesus. He's a prophet to Jerusalem, and he suffers greatly for speaking God's word. He speaks the truth, and he says in his prophetic utterances, God's word is a fire within him. He can't contain it. He has to speak it out, even though it brings him suffering. And so, the passage that contains part of his story here comes about because he speaks the truth to the citizens of Jerusalem that it would be better for them to surrender to the invading army because the odds are against them rather than take up arms and fight them. History would vindicate Jeremiah, and God's people who rejected him, who threw him in the cistern and left him there in the mud to die, later they would enshrine his words and his prophetic utterances as the very word of God. Even though they hated it, they came to realize that Jeremiah was speaking God's truth to them. In the gospel, Jesus speaks about fire too. Fire that he has come to set on the earth. He sounds just like Jeremiah. Fire of judgment. Fire of God's word. Fire of God's love. And the divisions that result of his preaching, Jesus speaks of the ways that homes and households are divided, families separated because of him and his word. Does this sound familiar? Is there a family that you know who doesn't experience some of this conflict and division that are sometimes at odds over belief? Family members tend to go different ways, you know. Children challenge and reject their parents' beliefs at times. Some just drift away or blame the church or God for problems. This is not new or surprising. It goes back to the very beginning, and this gospel reflects this. Family members who became believers and followed Jesus for the first time knew rejection in their families because they were stepping away from their traditional family religions, whether it was Judaism or some traditional pagan religion. Because they followed the new way, they were kicked out of their homes and ostracized, and households were divided, 3 against 2 and 2 against 3. It wasn't Jesus' intention or purpose to divide. His purpose was to bring peace. He said, and we acknowledge him as the Prince of Peace, but the sad result often was division. Now, division is not the problem, really. Jesus taught us to expect it. Issues of faith and conscience necessarily bring conflict because values are rooted in deep convictions and in faith, and not everyone shares these deep convictions or faith. Faith is a gift from God. The real problem is not being identified with Jesus, but not deciding, not taking a stand, or even being willing to suffer for faith and for following Jesus. So the author to the Hebrews, in our second reading this evening, knowing all this, beautifully encourages believers to persevere, not to grow weary, or to lose heart, or to give in to sin, but that we should keep our eyes fixed on Jesus. Keeping our eyes fixed on Jesus, the suffering servant of God, the prophet filled with the fire of God's love, this is our sure course. For 20 years here at St. Joseph, a faithful group in this parish has made devotion to the Eucharistic presence of Jesus their way to keep their eyes fixed on Jesus. For all of us who come here to this altar table, we keep our hearts fixed on Jesus when we listen to his word, are challenged by the gospel, and allow it to change us, to convert us to God's way. For our young people going off to college, and for all students, there are tons of challenges that they will encounter, tempting them to separate themselves from Jesus or see religion as part of the problem. For them, the challenge, as for all of us, keep our eyes fixed on Jesus. God's word is difficult today and challenging, but we need to hear this truth. To the man's email, question, is division in religion God's design? I responded, division comes from human design. It's our problem. God's plan for humanity is for us to be one, to be in harmony. Here is a closing thought from Thomas Merton, the American Catholic monk, mystic, who wrote about conflict and peace, integrity and faith. He said, "We are not at peace with others because we are not at peace with ourselves. We are not at peace with ourselves because we are not at peace with God." Let us keep our eyes fixed on Jesus. We profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Placing our trust in God, we offer our needs and prayers to the Father in Jesus' name.
Let us pray for the Holy Church. God, you know our struggles and our shame. May we always keep our eyes fixed on Jesus, your Son, and follow him with courage. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for goodwill among all people. May violence cease around our globe. Strengthen world leaders in their efforts to promote justice for the oppressed. Bring peace to the people of Egypt and all other troubled nations. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for perseverance in our Christian life. May we lay aside every encumbrance of sin that clings to us. Help us, O Lord, in our journey through life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the sick and the suffering. May those who bear a burden of pain not lose heart. We pray for especially Sherry Murray, Elena Zalek, Geraldine Lasik, Nanette Gates, Patty Edwards, Dan Breland, John Kalachewski, Cindy Lawson, Patty Lobos, Marge Massino, and for all who have asked for our prayers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us remember the dead. May Jesus, who has taken his seat at the right hand of the throne of God, welcome our beloved dead, especially Peter Francis, Phyllis, Gary, and Randy Party, Verna Sikora, and Jean Rolfson. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our personal needs. May our households accept the gospel and grow together in faith. Bless all students as they return to school. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of all creation, we feel your love in the sunshine of the summer day and all the care that surrounds us in your people, the church. Hear the prayers and needs that we bring in Jesus' name, who is our Lord, living with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Here
Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice.
Amen. Receive our gifts, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with a company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he, blessed is he, who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning are ceaselessly at work so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings and pour out on them the power of your Spirit so that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest love. For your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more giving you thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead and look forward to his blessed coming. We offer you, who are faithful and merciful God, the sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as we partake of this one bread and one chalice, we may be gathered into one body in Christ who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart, together with Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop. Help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her husband, the apostles and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we commend to your mercy. Then, freed at last from the wound of corruption and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Let us pray now to our Father in heaven, as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Through these holy sacraments, we implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to Christ's image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Let's be seated.
In your kindness, please remember the family of Peter Francis in your prayers. Mass of Christian burial was celebrated for Mr. Francis, the beloved husband of Katie Francis, this past Friday. Today in Marion Hall, you'll find an informational brochure about the Alpha Kickoff Dinner to be held on Thursday, September 5th. Please remember our religious education classes are filling quickly and the registration deadline is September 9th. Volunteers seeking to help in our religious education program or at our Sunday Children's Liturgy of the Word, please call the Faith Formation Office. Please also see the Voice or our website for information about the following: our fall scripture studies and other upcoming programs, the small group facilitator training session to be held on Thursday, August 29th, for those interested in becoming a table leader for one of our fall programs, and the Gospel of Life Committee's collection of signatures for the No Taxes for Abortion Insurance petition next weekend in Marion Hall. In honor of our Adoration Chapel's 20th anniversary, we invite everyone to Marion Hall following Mass for a cape reception. And lastly, a representative of our Holy Family Chapel, Bob Rancola, will share a few words about the ministry of our prayer and adoration of the Eucharist.
Good afternoon. My name is Bob Rancola. I have been part of the chapel for over 15 years. The chapel is and has been an integral part of my life during that time. Just as Moses met God face to face in the Sinai desert while sojourning the Jewish people, I have had the opportunity to meet Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament face to face for over 15 years. The development of continued weekly contact with Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament has helped me deal with personal problems, my marriage, family, and friends' interactions over the years. I would highly recommend this invitation to be with Jesus for your own lives and situations. Stop in the chapel 5 or 10 minutes and try it out. Then increase your time to an hour, and perhaps volunteer for an hour per week or join the sublist. Please come and join us after Mass in Marion Hall for a cake reception to celebrate, share, and learn more about our chapel. There will be tables there to sign up for an hour or to join the sublist. Don't miss this special event. Thank you.
Thank you, Bob. For 20 years, we've been a 24-hour, 7-day-a-week open place for people to come to pray. It's very unusual for a Catholic church. This chapel is always open. Many graces flow from here. People's faith has been strengthened. It's a great opportunity and an ongoing blessing for our parish. Katie Francis and Kevin are here tonight. Yesterday, you laid your husband and father to rest. Our condolences and our love to you. Katie, 43 years ago, you were married here at this altar with him. It's very hard. We have a young man here, Mike Moeller. Stand up. Today is your 21st birthday, and congratulations. I was a member of this parish when I turned 21, and I head down Baldwin Road to Wide Track Drive to have my first legal beer on my 21st birthday. But I think if you head down there now, there's quite a bit going on Woodward and Wide Track Drive. It might be not a good place to go. We have students returning to university, college, and grad school in our midst. Would you stand up, those who are heading back in the next few weeks? It's seminarian here, yes? People heading back to college? Let's impart a blessing. Yeah, Michael, you too. Good. We bow our heads. God of wisdom and love, we thank you for these students and for providing the resources for them to continue their educations. Bless and protect these students as they leave to begin their studies anew. Help them to remember that they are your beloved sons and daughters, made in your image and precious in your sight. Keep them healthy in mind, body, and spirit. And may these students keep their eyes fixed on Jesus and be witnesses to your light on their campuses. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We love you. Okay. Let's all stand and pray for God's blessings. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. We go now to bring the good news to all the world.
Thanks be to God.
Awake from your slumber.